That we're going to discuss today is compensation components. Now, as working professionals, we know what is compensation. The compensation is the money what we get for the job that we perform for any organization or company. So any benefits that is provided to the employee is called as compensation. We have another term in this chapter used as components. What is this components? When several parts make something, when something is made of several parts, we call that as components. So the title of this chapter itself tells us that compensation, that is the money that we get for the job, has certain parts in it. Now we're going to see in elaborate about these compensation components in chapter 7. Yes. So these are the various things that we'll be seeing in this chapter. First, the introduction about the chapter. And then what are the compensation components that are in this chapter? And then we establish a structure for the compensation. And at last, the review of the chapter. So this is going to be the agenda for the slides. Next one, sir. To start with, they have given the introduction for compensation. There's a saying. So friends, we can just relax and listen. May not be a rigid session. So there's a saying, well begin is half done. So if we begin this slide effectively, it is like half done with this chapter. I'm not just exaggerating, it is the fact that this single slide is gonna speak about the whole chapter that we're gonna see. So put our concentration, hearts and soul into this chapter by seeing the single slide. Now you can see a first term called as compensation structure. Compensation structure can also be called as compensation package. Now, let me give you an example. My kid is studying in UKG, upper kindergarten. Okay? To explain the structure of the plant, they showed a plant. They showed this is the root. This is the stem, these are the leaves, these are the flowers. Everything together is called a plant, right? The same thing, compensation package can also be called as compensation structure, which has some components like compensation grades and compensation plants. Just like parts of the plant, we have a compensation package, certain parts. Those parts are compensation grades and compensation plants. That's it. Now, let's see what is compensation grade. We'll be seeing these terms throughout this chapter. So I like to have a keyword attached with this concept so that we never forget what it is. So compensation grade, you can see a term, pay ranges. Okay. Compensation grade, the keyword used to explain compensation grade is pay ranges, range. Okay? So we use the general term, I have a certain range or to show up right. Now into the topic, the compensation grade, as I told you, the keyword linked to is the range. Range in job. Now take for example, CEO, or board of directors, or HR manager, finance manager. So we call them or categorize them under management roles or managerial roles. And a basic level employee, maybe a fresher or a candidate with 2 years of experience, we can categorize them as non-management related jobs. Okay, a range is fixed. So that is called as compensation grade. Now, in compensation grade, there's another subdivision. You can see the next point, compensation grade profiles. Again, the keyword linked to compensation grade profile is localization. you can see a term called as localization. So whenever you see this term, compensation grade profile, just remember localization. So what is that localization? Again, an example. HR manager. There are two HR managers in an organization. It's of same grade, same range. Now one HR manager is working in India. Another HR manager is working in US. Now the HR manager working in India has to be paid in INR, that is the Indian currency. The HR manager working in US has to be paid in USD, that is their currency. So that's all. The compensation grade profile is nothing but localization, which has been giving importance to the location where they are placed. So that's all with compensation grades. The next is compensation plan. Keyword. You can see a term, different types of pay. So what is compensation plan? Different types of pay. So what are the different types of pay? The basic salary, plus internet allowance, plus car allowance, plus mobile allowance, or maybe the housing allowance. So what are the other amounts or the allowances that has been linked along with the salary? So everything, that is the different types of pay. Now we can see a term at last, compensation package. We already began with the same one. So compensation package, what do we call it as a package? We collective of things is called as package, right? So with the general term of package, the collection of the compensation grade, the compensation grade profile, and the compensation plans, tied everything together. And what is used to tie everything together, we call that as eligibility rule. Okay, now in this package, what all we are putting? We are putting in compensation grade into it, compensation grade profile into it, compensation plan into it. We are tying everything together. We are tying this with something called as eligibility rule. So what is eligibility rule? Is nothing but conditions. Okay, the conditions. What will be the eligibility of a particular employee to get this particular grade pay, that is a range of pay, or in what location if he is, he will be given in this much of amount, or in what are the different types of pay will be given to a particular job profile. Now for everything the eligibility rule will be applied. So all this together we call it as compensation package. To put in a nutshell, compensation package is also called as compensation structure, which has two components, compensation grades and compensation plans. Compensation grades, it is pay ranges, which has another subdivision, that is compensation grade profile, which is the localization. Compensation plans is a type of pay. When everything put together with the eligibility rule applied, we call that as compensation package. That's it. Words as definitions, create. Okay, now this is actually the technical stuff what we'll be doing in Workday. So the technical stuff has been here given as statements. Now what is the first thing that is to be done in the compensation structure setup? We can see the first one, define compensation elements. Now what are called as elements? As we saw in the previous slide, compensation package has two components, that is compensation grade and compensation plan. Now compensation grade or compensation grade profile or compensation plan will have further subdivisions, okay, small details in it. Those small details are called as compensation elements. Let me give you an example to understand better. We know compensation grade profile. Can anyone say me what is the keyword linked with compensation grade profile? We saw the keyword. Very good. Yes, fabulous.
Pay ranges.
Yes. pay ranges is for grade, compensation grade. So for compensation grade profile, it is localization as exactly said. Thank you so much. Fine. So localization, we saw the location where he is placed. So the currency differs according to it. Now, what will be the compensation element for compensation grade profile is currency, that is whether it's USD, if it's in USA or INR in India, and frequency, whether it is hourly or monthly or weekly or annually. So that will be the compensation element for that component. Okay, so those inner details are called as the compensation elements. So first, those inner details have to be defined. That is, defined compensation elements. So only when that is defined, what can be done is a link between the compensation and the payroll earnings can be created. So payroll earnings, we can just take like the take-home salary what a person, an employee get is the payroll earnings. So the compensation package, what is defined, and the payroll will have a link only when these compensation elements are well defined. The next step is we need to create compensation eligibility rules. As said earlier, compensation eligibility rules are conditions. If he is in the position of manager or vice president, this will be his range, pay range. If he is working in Japan, then he'll be getting the local currency of Japan. Okay. And for this cadre, what will be the salary and what will be the allowances he'll be getting. So all this is the conditions. So that conditions has to be created, and we call that as compensation eligibility rules. After that, the next step is compensation plan and grade. We saw in detail about that in the previous slide. Compensation plans, again the keyword, different types of pay. Compensation grades, the keyword, ranges. Okay, so that has to be defined. So defined in the sense, we'll be giving, selecting the appropriate options, what has to be done in that. Okay, I told you the technical part given as a statement. Now at last, what we do is we have to just put everything together. We have to bundle it. So we'll be taking the compensation plan, compensation grade, along with eligibility rules, everything together will be done in the compensation package. So that is the last step. So this is compensation structure setup. Next slide, sir. Now compensation eligibility rules. Now friends, I told in the first slide, we're gonna see the same thing throughout. Now again, we're gonna see the same thing throughout. Now you can see in this diagram, the compensation package. It has two components, compensation grade and compensation plan. And these two are linked together or tied together with the eligibility rule. And this wholesome package is called as compensation package. So that is what we can understand. What we saw in the theoretical, the same thing is being given in the pictorial representation. Now, it also talks on the same thing. Okay. Now we can read along. You can also read along with me. You can see a compensation eligibility rule determines an employee's eligibility for each compensation component. So that's a condition. Eligibility is based on any combination of organizations. So based on the grades and plans. So at what profile he is, at what location he is, or what position he is. So based on all these, the conditions, the eligibility will be defined for an employee to get a proper compensation package. Now, by using compensation eligibility rule, these compensation components can default into an employee's compensation during a staffing event. Now, is defaulting necessary? Why can't we do it manually for each and every employee? When an employee's staffing event is nothing but hiring, or when we transfer, or when we promote or demote an employee, so all these are called as the staffing events, as well explained by Ms. Meenakshi in yesterday's previous session. So now we know that, is defaulting necessary? Take for example, if it is a very small company where only 50 or 100 employees are working there, then maybe in a month one or two staffing event may happen. So we can do it manually for each and every employee. But let's take an example of giant softwares like Google or Infosys or Cognizant. the Google, the number of employees working according to previous years, 1,39,995. For Infosys, it is 2,59,619. Cognizant, 2,89,500. For CPS, TCS, it is 4,17,929. Now imagine, okay, staffing event maybe every month, maybe few thousands of staffing events will be happening, like hiring or transfer or promotion, demotion, etc., etc. Now, can for all those thousands, can manual setup will work? Will never work. So defaulting is very important. Now, when will this defaulting happen? Take for example, TCS is hiring 7,000 freshers in next 1 month or 2 months. When all those 7,000 employee freshers are entering into it, then an eligibility rule is being fixed along with the job profile, that is the grade and the compensation pay is also linked along with the job profile. Okay, so for the job profile itself, for that cadre itself, the compensation for, package will automatically get defaulted. So eligibility condition, linking eligibility condition is something very, very important. Only then defaulting of it will happen during transition grades. Same thing we have seen about it already. Now under compensation grade, you can see our keyword range. Okay, the pay range is called as the compensation grade. Now for a employee's base pay, if range in the sense, take for example, a fresher may get a range between 25k to 30k. Can be the same pay range as a basic pay for a CEO? Not possible every month, right? So according to the level grade, what they are in, the pay range differs. So fixing up a pay range is important according to the, we call that as compensation grade. Now, for compensation grade, as we said earlier, eligibility has to be linked with it. So eligibility can be linked with it in two ways. You can see here two options are there, option 1 and option 2. At the end of the slide, you can see option 1 or option 2, but not both. So they have also given that you can either go with option 1 or with option 2, but both cannot be done simultaneously. Now let's see what is option 1. So option 1, what is that is, now you should understand what we are doing. We are for compensation grade, we are linking eligibility rule. We are tying eligibility rule along with compensation grade. So for that, what is option 1 is, tie compensation grade directly to the job profile. Okay, they are not giving eligibility rule for compensation grade. What they are doing is, we have to tie eligibility compensation grade along with job profile. Okay, because in job profile, when we go there, you can see a task called as edit job profile. So there we need to edit it and enter the eligibility rule, and that has to be linked directly with compensation grade. So this is just for defaulting. The main purpose of doing this is defaulting. Okay, now we can see the second one. In second one, they have given us, specify an eligibility rule on the compensation grade. The first option said that we are not going to give a compensation grade any eligibility rule. We are going to link compensation grade to the job profile with the task of edit job profile, where we'll be doing this also in it. That is, eligibility rule will also be tied directly when we do that edit job profile task. Okay. Second one is directly giving the eligibility rule to compensation grade. But it is also said in the below line that option 1 is the best when compared to option 2. So what do we understand from this one? That option 1 is the best one. Yes,
ma'am? Can you repeat it?
Okay, I can repeat it. So now you can understand this compensation grades, right? Compensation grade. Now, compensation grade or compensation plan, these are the two components in compensation package where eligibility rule has to be tied along with it. Now, for doing this eligibility rule tying up along with the compensation grade, it can be done in two options, option 1 and option 2. And it is also said that only one option can be chosen, not both. Now, what is the option 1 for option one, for the compensation grade, the eligibility rule has to be tied, right? They will not be giving eligibility rule directly to the compensation grade. What they do is, when they take the compensation grade, they go to job profile, they edit job profile. So in that technical thing, what we do is, in the job profile itself, okay, in the job profile itself, we'll be editing where we'll be giving the eligibility condition there, and then it will be linked along with the compensation grade. Can you understand? Okay, so here for the compensation grade, when you open compensation grade, okay, there we'll not be giving eligibility rule. What we do, we go to job profile, open job profile, there go and edit it, there we'll be giving the eligibility rule, and that will be linked along with the compensation grade. And this process is done for defaulting purpose. So any employee of this particular job profile is being hired in an organization, automatically his compensation grade and the value, that is the pay range, will be linked with it. Now can you understand, ma'am? Can you understand?
Yeah, it's clear. Thank you.
Okay. Yes. Okay, so that is what. And second one they have given, but second one we need not even see, because they are telling that the first one is the best one. You can also see a term called as recommended in bracket near option one. So the first one is recommended. Even when we go through the video for this compensation, seeing the trainer doing the same process. Okay, so this second one is for the compensation grade, directly they are giving the eligibility rule, but which is not very accurate. The first one is more accurate for defaulting process. The compensation grade profiles, we need not even look at it because we know it already. So what is the keyword linked with compensation grade profile? It is localization. Okay. Yes. So yes. So you can see the same term there, local. Okay. So localization here, in the sense, it is the currency of the location where they are working. Now you can see, for US, if a person is working in US, then USD is the currency to be given, the salary to be given in USD. If he's working in UK, then GBP. If he's working in Canada, then CAD. If he's working in Japan, then JPY. If he's working in Philippines, then PHP. If he's working in India, it is INR. That's all. So that's all compensation grade profile. Nothing worry. So as I told you, there are two elements. That is, one is currency and next one is frequency. When we do technical part, we can see there are two elements in it. One is currency and next one will be frequency, where we will be just choosing whether it's monthly or yearly, that is annually. Now, compensation grade, now we can see there are lots of subdivisions given. So all these are some of the compensation elements, okay, the elements that are found in this component, compensation grade. Now, the first element you can see, base pay elements. So what is base pay element is? The total base pay. The total base pay, you can see, it can be given in two ways. One is, it can be either a single compensation element or it can be a compensation element group. So what is a single compensation element? Maybe a fresher getting only the basic pay. So that is only a salary. Or it can be a compensation element group. So group of post collective. So it's basic pay plus car allowance plus mobile allowance plus internet allowance plus housing allowance, maybe the etc's will be added. So maybe both is possible. So that will be the base pay elements. Next we can see eligibility rules. So when we see eligibility rules, we should strike in our mind conditions. And why eligibility rule is very important for defaulting. So that is what we can see in the description. By associating compensation grade to the eligibility rule, the correct grade will default every time an employee's compensation is entered. Okay. So every time an employee's compensation is entered, automatically his grade and the value for the grade will be displayed. Okay, so this gives the person who's entering the salary confidence whether he's doing accurately or not, because everything is defaulted already. So that is the main role played by eligibility rule, defaulting. You can see reference by compensation package. Now here it's only for reference. So this gets displayed, okay? Displays the compensation package attached to the grade. Now, take for example, in the offer letter, if a particular cadre, okay, maybe the vice president cadre, they have given a particular grade, okay? So what grade they have been given, it gets displayed. Okay, that is for the reference, just for reference. So that displays the compensation package attached to the grade. That's just for the reference. The next one, compensation grade profiles. The compensation grade profiles, it is the minimum amount, the midpoint, that is the range, the maximum, the midpoint, that is between the minimum and the maximum amount. The segments is in level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. All these informations will be displayed as reference. And last is currency and frequency. The currency is the local money, what is being used in a particular location, and the frequency, that is whether it's hourly or monthly or annually, so that even that details will be included. So all these are the elements that are found in the compensation grades. Now, compensation plan. Now you should understand that we have completed the compensation grade, that is the first component. Now the second component, compensation plans. So what is compensation plans? The keyword, what we saw, is different types of pay. So in the different types of pay, the first one is the salary plan. Okay, one important pay is salary. That's the basic pay. And what will be the other types of pay? It will be the allowances. So after salary, we'll be seeing about allowance. Now in salary, okay, so it is in salary also, it is having only few important details. It doesn't have much details at all. In salary plan, we have to just enter the details like currency. You can see in the second line, currency and frequency. So based on the location, what will be the currency to be given? India means INR, US means USD. Frequency, whether it's on hourly basis or monthly basis, on what basis it should be given. Okay, so this will be done during the staffing process, like hiring or compensation change business process. Okay, and for one. So you can see the sample salary plan. You can see the salary plan. Yes. Now we can see the salary plan. They have given all XYZ employees. Salary will be given for everyone, for every employee in that organization. So of course the eligibility conditions will be linked along with it. Then you can see salary defaults, apply FTE. So FTE was again explained yesterday. Very well by Ms. Meenakshi, and FTE is full-time equivalent. Now, just for an understanding, just to have some light on it, okay, FTE is given in percentage. Now, take for example, if an employee is working for 40 hours, it has to work for 40 hours per week, okay? So, when he is working 40 hours a week, then he will be called as full-time employee, that is full-time equivalent. The percentage will be 1%. Now, out of 40 hours, if the employee is working only 20 hours, which means half of it, right? So, for 40 hours, if it's 1%, if he's working 20 hours per week, then half of it, that is 0.5, will be the FTE. If the same employee is working only 16 hours per week, then the FTE will be 0.4. Okay? If he's working for 24 hours, out of 40, 24 hours means, then his FTE will be 0.6. That's it. Okay? But we need not worry about the percentages. What we need to do is whether yes or no. If he is working 40 hours, yes, that is the full-time employee. If he is not a full-time employee, then it is no. Only that much what we need to concentrate right now. And you can see the compensation element, base pay. Okay. So here we need to apply FTE, we have to just check it and then exclude from merit, even that has to be checked. That's it. The next slide, sir, please. Compensation plan. As I told you, under compensation plan, the first one is salary plans. So automatically the next one will be the allowance plans. Okay. So allowances, we know what all the eligible expenses that employee can be paid off according to the eligibility condition. Okay, like maybe the internet allowance or car allowance or housing allowance or any type of allowances, whatever the employee is eligible of, he will be paid that. Now, when we see this allowance plan, this can be of three types. Okay, the element can be of three types will be displaying. So the three types, the first one is amount based, the second one is percentage based, and the third one is unit based. So what is amount based is? It is just the exact amount. Take for example, car allowance. Okay, car allowance may be in India. Okay, in India, maybe 2000 rupees is INR is paid as car allowance. Or maybe if a person is working in US, the car allowance will be 500 USD. So the exact amount, that is called as amount based. Percentage based. Percentages, they will not put the exact amount. The percentage from their basic pay. Okay. Maybe out of their basic pay, it is 2% as car allowance or 5% as housing allowance. So it will be given in percentages from their basic pay. So that is called as a basic percentage based. You can see the last one, unit based. Now the most frequently used is either amount based or percentage based. Very rarely with unit based, but just because it's given, we can also see what it is. Now all, maybe the car allowance or the internet allowance or the mobile allowance will be given in units. Okay, and for each and every unit what they are using, a value for each and every unit will be given. And the currency will be linked for each and every unit. So they will be entering the number of units. So when they enter the number of units, that unit has a value which also has a currency level. Okay, so that is a process in unit based. But which is not frequently used by most of the companies. It's mostly amount based or percentage.
Is percentage,
so you can see,
based on, is percentage based, can you please go for previous slide?
Yes. Previous
slide.
Can
you tell me about percentage?
Percentage based, yes.
Based, so previous slide. Depends,
yes,
on?
Yes.
Basic pay.
Now, amount based, you can understand, right? For, yeah, if I choose car allowance, the amount will be directly entered there. Take for example, yeah, 2000 INR. For percentage base, if we are choosing over, it is like options. Okay, we have to choose over which option. If you are choosing percentage base, we have to give only, we cannot give that 2000 INR. What we have to give is percentage has to be given. That, yeah, percentage, we have a basic pay, right? From that basic pay, this much of percentage will be given as car allowance.
Okay,
can you understand?
Yeah.
If my salary is 30,000 per month, out of 30,000, 5% will be taken as my car allowance. So that will be given. Okay. If the person is getting 3K, okay, not 3K, sorry, 3 lakhs per month, this 5% will be quite more, right?
More.
So yeah, based on the basic pay, the percentage will be given.
Okay.
Okay, that is percentage, yeah, based.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Now the same thing is given here. Now you can see the allowance plan. Here also we are having the FTE as is given. And for the frequency, it is given monthly. Okay, frequency is chosen as monthly. That's given in the box. And amount, you can see amount. Here it's been chosen the amount based. So that's the reason they have given an amount. If it's percentage based, they'll be given in percentage. So since amount based is chosen in this sample, you can see according to the currency and the location. Now, eligibility rule is attached to it. The country, USA. So, he's been given in 1,500 USD. But the employee working in UK, the amount given in their local currency, that is GBP in UK, or even its converted amount is also given. Okay, you can see the converted amount of that GBP in USD, that is 1,540.14. So this is the sample compensation package. Now we can understand that we saw, okay, what we saw in the previous one. We saw compensation grade, then we saw compensation plan. Now we are going almost to the last part, that is compensation package. So in compensation package, what you have to do? You have to package. Package with what? Compensation grade, compensation plan, along with eligibility rules, tied together, we get the compensation package. So that is what we can see here. A set of compensation grades and plans which are grouped together, we call that as compensation package. And how it is done? By creating a compensation package which with an eligibility rule or rules, you are able to default in compensation values, that is the salary grades or the allowances, etc. So during compensation events, so any type of hiring or transfer or promotion, demotion, any events is happening, okay, this compensation package will automatically default into it. We will not do for each and every staffing event when we are taking each hiring each and every employee. This process need not be done because it's already defaulted with the job profile, cadre, everything is linked. Even though eligibility rule is not a required field, okay, it is not a mandatory condition, because even for individual person, for individual staffing event, we can do it. But still, though it is not mandatory, but without eligibility rule, no compensation defaulting will occur during compensation events. Okay, so the main aim of linking eligibility rule is defaulting, so that each and every time we did not do it, okay, it gets defaulted for a particular cadre, that is for particular grade or particular job profile, it automatically gets defaulted. Notice that there are no eligibility rules for the compensation grades. So this is what we even had doubt in this, right? It was quite tricky, because even while the video, when we saw, the trainer himself was a bit stumbling over that concept. Okay, he was doing it twice because he went wrong in between. Now it is quite tricky, but we have to understand that eligibility rule should not be linked, okay, with compensation grade directly. But what we have to do, the best practice to have compensation grade tied directly to the job profile to establish eligibility. So eligibility will be done only when we go back to the job profile which was created already. Okay, not only during compensation, before that, the hiring process itself, the job profile will be fixed. So the job profile has to be edited. In that edit option task, we have to include the eligibility rule, and then it has to be linked along with the grade. So that will be the apt way to do. So now we can see. So in Kanyakumari district or Kerala, we call as Aviyal, right? So anyone know what is Aviyal? I'm from Kanyakumari, so our favorite dish is Aviyal. We put all the vegetables into one dish and we call that as Aviyal, okay? So whatever vegetables we get in hand, we put everything together and we call that as Aviyal. Now compensation packages are Aviyal, where we'll be putting the compensation grades, compensation grade profiles, compensation plans, and all the eligibility rules together, and we call that as compensation package. Now we can see compensation grade here, and the eligibility rule will be there already, and compensation grades you can see below, okay, and the compensation plans will be there, and even that will be linked. So everything put together, we get the now defaulting. Now here I like to read along with you. I mean, I like you all to read along with me, because some terms, if we register in our mind, will be much more better. But this is almost the end of this slide. Okay, this is almost the end. Now, when we read into it, what is default compensation concepts? So we saw the word defaulting was often used for the eligibility condition, that rules. Okay, now let's see what is this default compensation concept. So I just start with compensation defaulting hierarchy. Default compensation on position organization. Okay, that is the job position organization. If default compensation is set up on the position or organization, it will trump any compensation grade set up on the job profile and or any compensation eligibility rules. Okay, so the same thing, the words here are a bit confusing, but we have seen it already. When the job profile, okay, are being given the eligibility rule, which is being linked again with compensation grade, then this defaulting will happen. Okay, that is what is being given in default compensation on position organization. So we are starting with edit job profile. We are giving eligibility rule there, eligibility conditions. Okay, and then it is being linked along with compensation grade. Now next is compensation grade on job profile. The same thing is being given in different way. Here we are telling that only when we do the first option. Okay, we saw two options, and that the first option, that is the best. The same thing is given again. If the compensation grade is assigned on a job profile, then all employees assigned to the job profile are eligible for that compensation grade. Okay, when we link a compensation grade along with the job profile, then whatever employees are in a particular job profile irrespective of the compensation grade, sometimes if we give, take for example, for job profile, we are giving some rules, that is the conditions, eligibility conditions, and for compensation grade, we are giving some eligibility conditions, it will be having some kind of, it will conflict within each other. So that conflicting will be eliminated, okay? For this reason only, what is done, the best practice, a compensation grade should either be tied to the job profile or have eligibility rule, or but not both. Now, can you understand that point again? Okay. So, what is the best practice? What we do, that compensation eligibility rule has to be given to the job profile, and then it has to be linked with grades, job, I mean, compensation grade. When we do separately, it will have conflict, and that would cause some errors. So that's the reason they are asking, always go with edit job profile, then link it with compensation grade, and don't give directly eligibility for grades. The next one, eligibility rules on compensation components. During a staffing event, like hiring or promotion or transfer, anything, the employee and the organizational attributes, that is the supervisory organization or the level, etc., are validated against all available eligibility rules for a match. Okay, so when we fix eligibility rule, I told you eligibility rule is important for defaulting. So for any staffing event, maybe for hiring or promotion or transfer, whatever staffing event is happening, okay, it will be checked. Okay, it will be validated against all available eligibility rules for a match. Okay, only this is the main concept of default compensation concept. So default compensation during a staffing event is offered as a guidance only. Now, so user may even go and change or the offer, anything can be edited also, but this is only for a guidance. So this is a review, the end. So what all we saw so long has again been explained. So let's read once and we can understand. A compensation structure includes the compensation package where compensation grades and plans are grouped together. The first slide, what we saw. Allowances. So allowances has, okay, it can be of three types. We have to choose any one. So it can be percentage based or unit based or even amount based. As I told you, percentage based and amount based most frequently used by organizations. Unit based. Then the third one, compensation components for which employees are eligible can be controlled using eligibility. So that is the condition that is being given to the compensation components, that is grades and compensation. During staffing activities, the staffing events like hiring, promotion, compensation can be defaulted by using the defaults from the position or through the eligibility rule. So even manually, it can be done. For every individual employee, it can be done manually also. It also gets defaulted because we are using the eligibility rule in common for everything together. It's been tied. And the last point, during hiring, defaulting of the compensation details will only happen if the applicant is eligible for one and only one compensation package and compensation date. So for a particular job profile, okay, for a particular employee in a particular job profile, only one compensation package or grade is possible. It cannot be more than one. So that, let's walk through together into our technical session. So to tell the truth, we will be throwing more light only when we do it practically. Now, let us just discuss, okay? It is not just me talking. Let us just discuss what we understood by seeing into these templates. Because as I told you rightly, that we will be throwing more light only when we do it technically, practically into our workday. Now, the first one, we can see create compensation rules. Okay, the first one is creating compensation rule. Now, for creating compensation rule, so in the search box, we saw in the previous sessions that there will be a search box on the left side top corner, and we have to, in the search box, we need to enter as create compensation rule. So anyone that we are doing for the newly, it will be like create, and the other term that has been linked is maintain, which is already there, will be maintain. Now this is create eligibility, compensation eligibility. Now we need to select the task. So what is the task is create compensation eligibility rule task has to be selected. And in that we can see that the user ID is being given and the organization for all JMR Global Consulting for all the employees, the rule is being given. Now then we have to just click OK. Now when we go to the next one, create compensation eligibility rule task, we are navigating it. When we navigate, okay, when we move on into it, now we can see that we are choosing the level, that is the source essential level, I cannot see properly actually, that is management level. Okay, so we saw that the grades can be divided or can be subdivided into management levels and non-management levels. Now we can see, you also see that the comparison value is also given. What all will be coming under the management levels? We can see the board of directors, chief executive officer, executive vice president, director, manager. So all these profiles, okay, cadres comes under management level. So all this will be displaying. And we have to just click OK. Now we need to do the same thing. The next one is edit compensation rule. So after creating, so first we are creating it, then we go to edit. Okay, after creating it, then we'll be editing the compensation eligibility by choosing the edit compensation eligibility rule task. So there the user ID is being given and the manager and the above management levels. We saw some cadres, okay, some positions given. So all that positions will be coming under manager and above management level. And the rule condition has been accepted. Now we can not only the cadre, that is the range, grade is being selected. It is also the location is also mentioned here. You can see manager and above manager level in USA. The location has been selected and it has been clicked OK. Next, little more, sir. And creating compensation grades. Now eligibility rules are created. Okay, now eligibility rules are created. Now we are going into creating compensation grades. So we have to enter as create compensation grade in the search box. And throughout the, even in the video, we might have seen that they are giving yesterday's date. Okay, they don't select a particular date. They give yesterday's date because even explanation was given that from night 12 o'clock, it comes into account. Okay, so it is, the workday follows certain things, rules. So yesterday's date should be entered and the level. So there'll be levels, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. Level will be chosen as the range and use grade profiles. So grade profiles in the sense we need to choose over the location. So when you choose over the location, automatically the elements like currency and frequency will be given, where we can see for currency USD is given and frequency monthly is being selected. And under compensation pay range, we can see the compensation base is being given, that the total base pay, and it is being checked on. And next is compensation grade profile tab is being selected. So compensation grade profile is here the different countries have been given as examples. Now we can see a grade profile in the sense localization, as we saw in the theory part. So localization in the sense where the employee is working. So we can see the eligibility rule country Philippines is given and the minimum amount is being given. And you can also see the currency as PHP, which is the currency of Philippines. And frequency monthly. So these two are the two important elements in compensation grade profile. The same example has been given for the country India. You can see the amount and INR and monthly, and same thing for America, okay, in USD and monthly. We have to just click OK. And now grade profile has been created. Next, automatically what we should come, compensation plan. So after eligibility rule is being created, then we created the eligibility compensation grade. Now the next should be the compensation plan. So in compensation plan, we saw the theory part. We have to first create the salary plan and then go to the allowance plan. So here you can see the salary plan has been created. Okay, so we have to create salary plan and then yesterday's date has been given. So under salary plan, it is the main importance will be given for the FE. We have to check it and then you have to give the user ID. So after allowance plan will be there, after salary plan, allowance plan. So allowance plan also the same thing. So allowance that, what type of allowance is this? So here we can see allowance plan has been created and SDHC is given, and they have selected amount based plan. So out of three, amount based or percentage based or unit based, they have chosen amount based plan. So here we have to enter the amount. So you can see the amount will be entered. Now you can see the amount 50, the currency will be USD, because the location is based on the location, not only the country or the particular location. You can see for same America, Boston, it is USD is being given 50. In same America, Atlanta means it is being given in 100 USD dollars, US dollars. Okay, and it has to be clicked on. Now we have completed with, we did eligibility rule. Okay, then we created eligibility, not eligibility, compensation grades. Then we saw compensation plans. In compensation plans, we saw salary plan and allowance plan. All these has been created. Okay. So now the last one, we have to put everything together. So that is creating compensation package. Now we have to select over create compensation package, that we have to select that task, compensation grade, then compensation profile plans and the eligibility rule, everything together it has to be done. So that technically, since we have created everything, we'll be linking in compensation package, we'll be linking everything, the grades, plans and its eligibility rules together, and we click OK. So that's the end of the compensation components. That is the compensation package.